Hello everyone, Daft here with you. I figure it'll be a good time to do another video in regards to the ILS A320 I made not too long ago. Like last year, September. Well, that was because I was using the default version A320, and around that time, I wasn't really aware about the fly-by-wire mod. But a lot has changed over the past months on the A320, which made it more playable and enjoyable. But not a lot changes in regards to ILS procedures or approaches, I mean. But a lot of things change visually in regards to A320 that makes it more realistic as much as possible. Because if you saw the default version, you'd know what I'm talking about. That's why I'm going to post it around this screen, somewhere around here. If not, it'll be down in the description for you to check it out yourself. So I decided to replicate the same ILS approach I did in that previous video that I made in September. We're using ILS or LOCalizer runway 26, but we're going to do an ILS as usual. To Julia Alpha X-ray, Jacksonville International, and then I'm gonna do a quick brief just to get an idea what's to expect during this approach. So the localizer will be 110.3, the approach course will be 257, runway length that we have is 10,000, touchdown zone elevation is 27, and airport elevation is 29, so two difference pretty much. Now of course you have their notes in below it. On the right is your Mauser, that's the lying system. And then next out, and then up across is your missed approach. That's an event if you don't have the runway in sight around the minimum. You'd go around, and then you follow the procedure as follow, which is climb to 3,000 directed DINs, LOM, and hold. Then you're going to continue to climb and hold to 3,000. And of course below we have your frequencies, such as ATIS, JAX approach, tower, ground control, clearance delivery. Now if you look in the bottom, you'll notice there's a straight in ILS 26 or S-ILS. That's what you would be using mainly for approaches like the ILS or localizer, for example, straight in. So Airbus is a category C aircraft, so we're going to take 227 regardless, because that's the minimum decision height. So on the MCDU, you would put an approach plate, the approach page in the barrel, that is, because previously it was MDA or DH, I believe. So you would put an ILS Cat 1. During Cat 2, Cat 3 approaches, you would use the radio instead because it's sensitive. The lower it is, the more sensitive, so that's why. I'll just self-vector because ADC is not reliable at this point. But we'll be hanging around 2,000 feet. I will be descending to 2,000 feet towards Tickery intersection. And by the time we cross over to Tickery, we can descend to 1,600 until we're established on the GlideSlope capture point or we're across Delton. But by that time, the GlideSlope should be active and we should be able to capture it prior to reaching Delton. So I'm actually utilizing the fly-by-wire update before I actually used the experimental version, which they made their own custom fly-by-wire, autopilot, FADIC, you name it. Now in this video, I made this video before I actually updated that version. So you're gonna notice we're gonna do Cat 3 single, although currently you can do dual Cat 3 dual. By the time we reach Tickery intersection, I'm gonna arm the approach, and by that time it should be able to capture once we're close to Tickery intersection, mainly the localizer. So there's two things you're gonna do in the ILS approach. You're gonna capture the localizer and then a GlideSlope. So you see now the local, you have Lockstar. That means is that we're capturing a localizer. The aircraft will follow it laterally. Now it might be possible it might overshoot it, but if it does, it'll correct itself until it's established. And from there, it'll say lock, which means we've captured the localizer. And now once we're across the ticker, we can descend down 1600. Open descent. And of course, once you're on a localizer, you want to make sure you put your LS buttons on. Set your auto brake to low or medium. I'll use low for now. And then around 5 miles, we're going to start to configure the aircraft to landing. So on 5 miles, we're going to put flaps 1, 4 miles, flaps 2, 3 miles, we're going to put the gear down, arm the spoilers, 2 miles, we're going to put flaps 3, and then 1 mile left, we're going to put the last full configuration. And by that, we should be ready. We should be in good configuration. By the time we should be in landing configuration, ready to establish on the GlideSLope capture. Now you'll notice that the purple diamond's already going down, so that's the GlideSLope right there. Once it crosses over the yellow line, that's your altitude that you're in right now, it's going to start capturing a GlideSLope star. At that point, you're going to have to adjust your missed approach altitude, which is 3,000 as stated above. In case you don't have the runway sight, or you're unstabilized, or you're making an unstable approach, you would have to go around. So watch, notice the purple diamond, what we usually call magenta, I'll just call it purple, just for simplicity. And I'm going to set the LS rose page on the ND. Now watch the capture right now, so you notice it's GlideSLope, you set your missed approach 3000. And then from there, the aircraft will follow all the way down the minimums of 227. As you see, it's always good to be ahead of the game and not play catch up. Because if you're going to be far behind, it's not a good thing. So you want to be ahead of the game, prepare the aircraft as much as you can, keep on the checklist, you name it. Now if you notice on the ND, it also has the same GlideSLope and localizer, purple diamonds. Of course, now if you look at the top right, bottom left of the PFD, it tells you the localizer frequency. Now around the altitude, around 227, is our minimum. You'll hear a call out minimums. Now notice by the time I'll gonna have fly go visual from there once we're at minimums. You're going to notice that the happy lights are two reds, two whites, which is good. That means we're on glide. So I'll disconnect all the power right now, and we're going to hand fly all the way down to touchdown. So all you got to do is follow the lights, make sure it's two reds, two whites, means you're on glide. Anything away from those parameters, if it's three lights, you're definitely high. Or slightly high, excuse me. And if you're three reds, you're slightly low. And you just got to correct it. Minimum. So you can see right now it's slightly high, so we're just going to correct it to make sure we're two reds, two whites. Now we're back to glide. Around 20 feet, we're gonna pull the thrust to idle, let and then flare from there. Make sure the back of the wheels come down first before the nose.
20. 10.
And then we're good. Touchdown. Then we're gonna do reverse, full reverse. First, we decel. Spoilers are already deployed. We're decelerating as it is. So this is how I do an ILS approach. This is just an update, it's nothing new. I'm just here to show the visual difference between the default and the fly-by-wire version, which makes a difference. I mean, it makes a difference very much throughout the months. They've done a lot of work and excellent improvements towards the A320. So that's why I figured it could be a good time to make an updated version of the ILS to show you what changes were made and how far we've come to this point where we're close to having a free study level aircraft. And of course, let's not forget about the A380 that's about to come up, which I'm very pumped up about. Hopefully the A380 becomes even more exciting than the A320 itself. So anyway, that's pretty much it for the ILS approach. Thanks for watching, and I'll be seeing you guys next week. Take care.